friends. Welcome back to my channel and happy Friday. I'm actually filming this video on Thursday because we are heading out camping to Priest Lake for the weekend. So I won't be here to attend my virtual workshop on Friday and film and edit and upload this video for you guys. So I decided to go ahead and weigh in one day early. So I went ahead and weighed in this morning, hopped online, printed off the information on what we're talking about at the virtual workshop. And I thought before we headed out of town that I would film my weigh-in for the week, one day early, of course, as well as the topic that we would have discussed at the virtual workshop. It's quite interesting. I'm able to download, print the weekly so I can see what we were going to talk about. I just don't get the additions of my leader and the other people that are part of the virtual workshop, but I really like this topic and I think that I can share some valuable insight with you guys, even though I didn't actually get to attend the virtual workshop. So without further ado, let's jump into the workshop and my weigh-in. So this week's topic is taking charge of unhelpful thoughts. Now, in a nutshell, this basically means that if you find yourself at the bottom of a box of cookies and you've eaten the entire box, what was the cause of you doing that? Were you telling yourself, I'm not losing any weight, I can't do this, I might as well eat these cookies, it's quarantine, I'm gonna eat what I wanna do, this is my reason to eat whatever I want to eat, or I'm extra hungry today, I'm just gonna go ahead and eat this whole box of cookies and I'll just figure it out later and start over tomorrow. So those are some unhelpful thoughts that we can tell ourselves that lead us to do things that maybe we generally wouldn't do if we weren't having these unhelpful thoughts. So today we're gonna talk about what these thoughts are and how to combat these so that we don't find ourselves at the bottom of an empty box of cookies. So let's use an example that I've honestly done myself more than once, several times. And that is we screw up. We eat something that knocks us out of our smart points budget. Maybe we splurge or we have an extra cheat day and we think, great, I've ruined my entire week. I'll just start over next week. And we continue to eat poorly the rest of the week. Who's done that? I've done that more times than I care to admit, to be completely honest. So we're gonna use this as our example on how to stop these unhelpful thoughts. So when we find ourselves telling in our mind out loud, we've ruined our week, we're just gonna give up for the rest of the week, the rest of the month, the rest of the year, we need to shift those into positive thoughts. For example, if you splurge and ate a cheat meal and you're way over your points, you're in the negative of your weeklies, tell yourself, it's okay, I can start over on my next meal. I can start over tomorrow. One slip up or eating all of my weeklies may not even impact my weight loss. I'll make it up with eating good the rest of the week. So see the difference in how we talk to ourselves and what thoughts, whether they're helpful or unhelpful, we tell ourselves that really could lead us to a positive or negative result. If I tell myself I've ruined my day, I'm just gonna go ahead and throw the towel in this week and eat whatever I want, chances are I'm going to see a gain, maybe even a large gain on the scale. But if I shift my unhelpful thoughts to positive thoughts and I say, okay, today's over. Did I screw up? Absolutely, but I'm starting over. I'm gonna get right back on track and combat today and see that loss on the scale at the end of the week. I love this second one, and this is give yourself a reality check. Give yourself a freaking reality check. If your friend, loved one, family member, fellow WWer came to you and said, oh my God, I have ruined my entire week. I had McDonald's, I had fries, I had a burger, I had all the things. Would you tell your friend, yeah, you're right, you ruined your entire week, you might as well just throw in the towel? No, you would tell your friend, just get back on track, the next meal, the next day, whatever the situation may be, and you can make up for your little bit of a screw up. That's what you would tell your friend. You wouldn't flush your friend's progress and future on WW right down the toilet. So don't do that to yourself. Don't tell yourself you've ruined it when in reality, you can simply start over and get back on track. And chances are you may even make up for that little splurge on the scale and still see a lot. It comes down to all or nothing thinking. And that is me, you guys. That is me in a nutshell. Jen, all or nothing thinking, Clayton. That should be my name, because I am like that. I'm either 100% in or I'm 100% out. And I am like that in so many areas of my life. And I know that about myself. I'm extremely self-aware, and I know that about myself. So when I start that all or nothing thinking when it comes to WW, and I do that probably once a week, to be completely honest with you, I find myself in my pantry wanting to have cookies or something I shouldn't eat. And I say, well, if I'm going to have a cookie, I might as well eat the whole box because I'm having a cookie. I have been practicing changing my unhelpful thoughts to helpful thoughts and telling myself, you can have one cookie, track it, and move on. You don't need to eat the whole box. Now, am I successful every time? 100% no. There are times I eat the whole box. I'm not gonna lie. You guys know I am honest with you, and that is the honest truth. There are times that I let the unhelpful thinking get in the way, the all or nothing attitude. But I've really been trying to be mindful of when I catch myself in that all or nothing attitude, that all or nothing mindset, and trying to shift out of that so that I'm not sabotaging my weight loss. Let me know down in the comments if you're similar to me, where you do have that like all or nothing mentality. It's tough. It's tough to move past that, but you just have to figure out that you are like that and do your best to make changes when you find yourself getting into that mindset. And lastly is accept and act. Accept that you made a mistake and act on it positively. Start over, start fresh, make a game plan to get out of that all or nothing mindset. If you're in that, to get out of that, I've already ruined my whole week, my whole day, my whole month, my whole weight loss journey, and shift it into something positive. I sometimes struggle with the get back on track on the next meal. That isn't always how my mind works. For me, sometimes it has to be the next day. Sometimes I just want to throw in the towel for the entire day, and I tell myself the next day I'm getting right back on track. And I don't think there's anything wrong with that, as long as we are getting right back on track the next day or the next meal or whatever it is that we promised ourselves. So I like this topic a lot. I feel like it really resonates with me, and man, this is raw and uncut. You guys are getting a lot of truths thrown your way from me today. So I am really guilty of this, especially the all or nothing mindset, and I'm glad that I'm able to recognize that so that I can try to improve upon that and make that better throughout my weight loss journey and really my life in general. I find myself with that mindset in my life. So for me, that is a big focus, and I've really, really been working on that throughout my weight loss journey, especially over the last few months when I've really been able to identify that that's kind of how my mind works. So bottom line is, take those unhealthy thoughts and turn them into healthy thoughts. And remember, and I think this is huge, you guys, tell yourself what you would tell your friend or your loved one. Don't be so hard on yourself if you wouldn't be just as hard on someone you love. So now that I've just thrown who knows how many truth bombs your way, let's talk a little bit about my week. So as you know, like I mentioned, it's only Thursday, so I'm one day early in my weigh-in, but I had a pretty good week this week. I did track calories and smart points. I'm trying to do an experiment before I actually put out my what I eat in a week calories versus points. Speaking of calories, yesterday I uploaded my how to figure out your calories video. You guys have been begging for calorie videos, macro videos, so I did a little mini series, and this was the second one in that series where I talked about different ways to figure out your calories using the WW app, using other apps, and the reason why we should watch our calories even though we're on WW. So make sure you guys check that out. Also, a couple weeks ago, I updated my point or uploaded my points versus calories video. Highly recommend you watch that as well. That was the first one in this four-part mini series about calories versus points. So I took that to heart this week and really did track both calories and points. I stayed within my calorie range this week, which was my goal. Did I stay within my points? Not every day, but I made sure that I stayed within my calories. More to come on this, of course. And when I stepped on the scale today, even though it was one day early, I'm down 1.2. I'm incredibly proud of myself for that. I am loving this new little bit of approach and this new thinking that I have towards my program, and it seems to be working. So I'm starting June off with a bang, being down 1.2 pounds. I told myself June is going to be a good month. June is going to be more than a 3 or 4 pound loss at the end of the month. I'm committed to that. So I'm heading out camping this weekend. Like I said, camping can be a little bit of a struggle for me, but I am on my way right now to do my grocery shopping and I have several healthy meals planned. I'm going to film the entire thing, which really helps me stay on track as well. You guys love coming camping with us, seeing what we're doing, Diesel and Lola. So stay tuned for that video coming out this next week. And I am looking forward to another successful week. I mean, that's really the bottom line, camping trip included. I'm going to stay on track. I'm going to use my weeklies on Friday tomorrow, so that I can have a s'more or something in the afternoon as a sweet treat. And then we're gonna have hamburgers for dinner, which I'm super excited about. Hamburgers are my jam. It's one of my favorite foods and I want like a big greasy burger. So that's what we're gonna have for dinner tomorrow night. I should be getting in lots of activity with walking to and from the lake and I can't wait to just get away, relax, and be in peace for a few days camping. So this week also was not my week for exercise. I actually didn't do jazzercise at all, but I did spend quite a bit of time in my yard. In fact, yesterday I had 90 active minutes just in my yard, spraying weeds, pulling weeds, and I did one more thing, can't remember what it was, something else for my husband, and I ended up with about 90 active minutes in the yard. So I am back on the jazzercise bandwagon next week. This week was just crazy. It kind of threw me for a loop. This was a busy week and I'm happy to know that I can still lose weight when things are thrown my way and it's a busy week. So that in a nutshell is how everything went for me this week, and I'm excited to go camping and for a successful week and second weigh-in for the month of June. So I want to hear how you guys are doing. How was your week? Did you gain? Did you lose? Was it what you expected? What's your thought on this unhealthy thoughts that we put into our head? Do you find yourself in the same boat that I am, where you're all or nothing, or you tell yourself unhealthy thoughts when it comes to making mistakes on your journey? This really, really resonated with me. And like I said, I'm sorry for all the truth bombs, but I wanna be honest and transparent with you guys. And this is actually something I do struggle with in my Weight Watchers journey. And like I said, in my life in general. So I like this topic and it really just kind of puts it back in the forefront of my mind, which is really, really helpful. So thank you guys so much for hanging out with me today. I hope you have a great Friday. If you're new, I'd love for you to stick around and join my channel. Just hit that little subscribe button and that bell so you're notified when new videos are uploaded. I do a weigh-in every Friday and I do upload most other days of the week. Make sure you're checking out yesterday's calories video. Give this one a thumbs up if you love the weigh-ins. And of course, I'll see you guys all in the next video. Have a fantastic weekend and I'll see you actually in tomorrow's massive, and I mean massive, grocery haul. See you guys then. Bye. My darling, I love you. I love you.